Hey there, folks. Andrew here at Chatfuel. Today, of course, we're talking all about the brand new Facebook Shops entry point. And this is super exciting if you are selling products through shops. And that's because normally shoppers are going to have questions about the products you're selling and you have to manually answer them. You have to take time out of your day to provide those responses to their questions. But now with this Facebook Shops entry point, you can use a chatbot to automatically answer your shoppers' questions, making them more likely to buy. So if that sounds interesting to you, then stick around because we're going to help you boost your sales. But before we do jump into the tutorial, one quick housekeeping tip here, and that is that when you are first setting up your Facebook shop, make sure that your checkout destination is set to Messenger, not a website, for example. Otherwise, this entry point will not work. So keep that in mind. Make sure to use Messenger as your checkout destination. Now, all of that being said, let's jump into Flow Builder and show you how to set this up. So here we are in Flow Builder in the Flows tab, and we're going to start by actually adding this entry point to a flow. So we've got this blank canvas here in our flow. I'm going to double click on the canvas and add, you guessed it, the Facebook Shops entry point. Now, one other quick note here, when you are using shops, I would highly encourage you to create one dedicated flow for everything shops related, for all the shops entry points that you're using. Yes, technically you can use the shops entry point anywhere in your chatbot, in any flow, but again, I recommend just kind of keeping them all in one flow. Otherwise, in my view, it can get kind of messy and confusing. So once we've created this shops entry point, I'm going to choose a specific product. And technically here, you can choose between specific products or all products. But in my view, all products, again, can be pretty confusing. So my best advice, my best practice here would be for each shop entry point that you have, choose one product. So one product per shops entry point. You can create as many shops entry points as you want though. So if I have 10 products, I would create 10 shops entry points. And again, all of that is within a single flow. So just some organizational stuff, but now let's get into the fun stuff. So I'm going to choose a specific product here from my Facebook shop. And in this homemade pasta catalog, I'll select rigatoni, for example. Again, one product per shops entry point. So now that we have that set up, I can, you know, hover over this and click it. It'll take me to that product page, but we'll do that in a little bit. And then once we've selected the product, we actually have to set up the rules, the questions that we anticipate shoppers will be asking us, and then set up those responses. So here for each keyword group, we're going to type in a question or different ways of asking that question that a user might send us. So for this first one, for example, let's type in something like how much protein per serving. And I could type in some different variants, some different ways of asking this, right? So maybe I say, how much protein per serving is there in your rigatoni? Or different keywords that would make me think as the business owner that, hey, this is what the user is asking about. But in this case, we'll just keep it simple, just have this one phrase here, how much protein per serving? And again, if we wanted to add different questions, like if a user asks, you know, what recipes go well with this pasta, we could add a different keyword group for that. And we could add another for, I don't know, what ingredients are in your pasta, et cetera. But again, for simplicity here, we'll just keep it simple with one question and one response. Now, to create the response to this question, the answer to that user, we're going to click this connector right here and drag it over, and I'm going to delete this product card here, more on that later. And let's add some content like text and buttons. And here we can provide that answer, right? So we can say something like 7 grams of protein per serving. Okay, simple enough. So we have the user's question here about this product, and then we are providing the answer to that question. Now, one other thing here before we go in the wild and test this, for this all other messages category right here. So if the user asks a question that we don't have a response set up for, then we're going to take them down this other pathway. And my best practice here would be to use live chat, send them to live chat so that the agents managing your page inbox can easily see what users need assistance versus those who already had their question answered by the chatbot. So to do that, I'm going to again double click on the canvas here. and choose bot action. And then within bot action, I'm going to choose live chat. And again, connect this connector right here to that action for live chat. Okay, so simple enough, we have this set up for the Rigatoni product. If they ask this question on the product page, we're gonna give them this answer. If they ask anything else, then we'll send them to live chat. So now last thing I have to do here is toggle on this switch, this entry point to actually activate it. And now we can click on the product image here to test it in the wild. So I'll do that. And here we go. So I'll click message and I'll type in that question. How much protein per serving? Send message. And there we go. We get that automated response. And now as the customer, as the shopper, I have the confidence that I need to actually complete this purchase. Now, one other thing that I want to mention here, if we go back into Flow Builder, and that is the product gallery plugin. This is a new plugin, a new feature that is associated with the shop's entry point, but actually you can use it anywhere in your chatbot, which is super exciting. This is a great feature for cross-sells, upsells, product recommendations, anywhere in your chatbot, anywhere in the conversation where you want to showcase a product or a collection of products to your chatbot users. So what do I mean by that? Well, if we add content to this message right here. And again, it doesn't have to be directly connected to the shop's entry point. It can be anywhere in your chatbot, but I'll click add content here. And if I scroll down to the bottom, we see product gallery, and I'll just delete this live chat actually to make more room here. And then we can click to add a product and import that product from our shop. So this saves you all the time of manually uploading images and prices and URLs, all of that. It imports that card, that product, directly from your shop. So if I click here to add product, you'll see I can add something like this high protein marinara sauce. And again, this is a perfect example of using this for a cross sell, right? Because a user is asking a question about the rigatoni, specifically how much protein it has. And so then we can say, hey, here's your answer to the question, but also here's another product that you might be interested in since you want high protein food, right? So here's a high protein sauce. And of course, marinara sauce goes well with rigatoni as well. So that is how the Facebook Shops entry point works at a high level. Obviously, the underlying goal here is to help you automate your frequently asked questions, automate your shoppers' questions that you're getting through Facebook Shops so that you can increase your sales and obviously save time in the process. You don't have to be manually responding to all of these messages. So if you have any questions about the Facebook Shops entry point whatsoever, be sure to leave them in the comments down below. Otherwise, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video and happy botting.